Good evening, good evening, good evening. Come on into the room, saints of God. Come on into the room. Please share. Let people know that we're here. God bless you. God bless you. Come on into the room. God bless you. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Good evening, everyone. Please share. Please indicate your city and state. We're getting ready to get started in just a second. I do want to allow people an opportunity to come in. Thank you for joining. As always, I'm Apostle Regina Spivey. Please share. Welcome, 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 welcome. Welcome. Come on in. Come on in. I'm excited about what God is going to do this day. Come on into the room. Welcome, welcome. Glad to have you this evening. Come on in. Please share. Please share. I want you to comment. I want you to send some hearts. Get your pencil and paper. Make sure you have pencil and paper so that we can study the things of God. Good evening, Sister Tasha. God bless you. Coming in from North Carolina. God bless you all. Please share. I just want to give a few more people a few minutes and we're about ready to start this evening. I'm excited. We're always talking about kingdom principles, laws, and promises. So I'm excited about what God is going to do this evening. Make sure you have your Bibles because you will need those. Because remember, we're students of the words and we're going to be learning new things this afternoon. God bless you all. Come on into the room this evening. Good evening, Evangelist Demetrius. Please put your city and state in there for us. God bless you. God bless you. Glad to have you this evening. Good evening, good evening, good evening. Good evening, good evening, good evening. I'm going to go ahead and get started. Today is Thursday. What is today? Thursday is what? Transformation Thursday. Somebody put in the room for me, Transformation Thursday. This is the day that the Lord has set aside for us to talk about what? Kingdom keys. We talk about kingdom laws, we talk about kingdom promises, and we talk about kingdom principles. This is our school where we get an opportunity as a believer to understand the things that God has called for us, to understand as it relates to the laws, the principles, and our behaviors, the actions that he expects of us. And so this evening, I'm going to encourage you, saints of God, as always, I'm Dr. Regina Spivey. If you would also get your pencil, your paper together, if you would get your notes, your Bibles, and we're going to jump into this theme and we're going to get started. You guys type in there Transformation Thursday. Let us know where you're coming in from and we're going to go ahead and get started. I just want to say to you, I thank God for each and every one of you. And Lord, right now, we pray right now on this live that the people will be healed, delivered, and set free, that souls will be saved, and that we will learn how to operate in the kingdom of God here on earth and understand the principles, the laws, and the promises and how they apply to us so that we can be better people, so that we can maneuver in the kingdom as kingdom citizens. That is my prayer for this evening. Thank you if you're just joining us again. This is Transformation Thursday. I am Apostle Regina Spivey. We're talking this month, December is our series on what God gave me for the year of 2021. Someone type in there, the word that God gave for the year of 2021 is clarity. Somebody put in there clarity. 2021. God is going to make everything very clear to us in the year of 2021. We won't have to guess. We won't have to wonder. We don't have to try to figure things out and wonder which direction we're going to go. But God is going to make it very clear for us in 2021. Is there anybody excited about what God is going to do and what he's going to provide for us in 2021? When he gave me that revelation, he also said in these four areas, this is in which God is going to make it clear for us. First, God is going to extended grace for us in 2021. Somebody put in there extended grace. It's going to be an extended of grace. There's going to be an extension of mercy in 2021. I don't know about you, but I can use an extension of grace, his unmerited favor. I can also use his extra compassion. In 2021, God is going to extend his grace unto the believers. Oh my God, I'm excited about that. And also, in addition to the clarity that he's going to give us in number 2 year of 2021, God also wants to stabilize you. Somebody put in there, stabilize. God is going to stabilize you in all areas of your life, starting with your mind. You're not going to be double-minded, because why? God is going to create clarity in every decision, every walk, every thought, every action in which you have. So the second area that God is going to deal with us as believers in 2021 would be in the area of stabilization. He's going to stabilize you in 2021. He's going to make sure not only is he going to grant and extend additional grace, but he's going to stabilize you in the things of the kingdom. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The third thing that God is going to do in 2021, he's going to extend grace. He's going to extend, he's going to stabilize you. But the third thing is God is going to provide, he's going to give provision. He's going to meet the needs of the saints. Saints of God, I need you to hear me. Needs that will support that of your soul, that as a believer, your health, your welfare, not just financially, but God is going to provide for you in every area that you need. Some of you are wanting to do ministry and ministry full time, and you're saying, Lord, I don't have the resources. But God said, provision is yet to come. Somebody say, provision is yet to come. God in 2021 is extending. He's going to extend provision to you. Oh my God. I don't know about you, but this has been a very unusual year, a year where I needed God's grace. I needed extended mercy. I needed stabilization. And then I also needed extra provision. And God is going to make a provision. He's about to make a way out of no way. Just think about it. We're only a few days out before the year ends that God is about to bring us up. What do we say? God is preparing us to bring us what? Up, so that he can bring us out, so that he can bring us over. God is about to cross us over into new territory. Come on, somebody, type that in there for me. God wants to bring you up. He wants to bring you out, and he's about to take you over. Oh my God. When I think about his goodness and all that he does, I'm excited about it. Saints of God, I want you to understand the word clarity is what he gave for 2021. And he gave four subcomponents with that. We talked about grace. We talked about where he's going to stabilize you. He's going to also provide provision. But I heard God say prosperity. Somebody type in there, prosperity. Prosperity is yours, says the Lord. God is about to give you prosperity, saints, not only in your finances. Look beyond just finance, but God wants to give you prosperity in your health. He wants you to live a prosperous life in your mind, your body, your soul, and in your spirit. Stop narrowing God. Stop trying to put him in just one box. God is greater than just your finances. He's a healer. He's a deliverer. He's a burden maker. He's a way maker. He breaks yokes. Stop putting God into a box. Oh my God. It's not about putting him in a box. It's about allowing God to be God. Allow God to expand in your life. Allow God to give provision for you. Allow God to prosper you in the things that he has for you. God desires that you should have a life of an abundance, a life of overflow, more than enough. Come on, somebody. Is there anybody out there that believes that God wants to do those areas for you? And so I just want to share the 2021 vision, but we're going to talk about, we started talking last week about purpose, but this week we want to talk about, I want to talk to you about, in order for God to move in these areas, there's an action required of us. I want to talk to you about what is called spiritual stability. Somebody type in there, spiritual stability. God is wanting you and needing you in order for God to do the things that he requires of you. There's an expectation on your end. He has called for a call and response. Oh my God. God is saying right now, you have to be stabilized spiritually. And so what are you saying about that, Apostle? So let's just kind of dig into this thing. The first thing we want to talk about as transformers, because we come on here every Thursday to learn and to grow and to understand what we can do differently, what we can do better as believers to help us prosper in the things of God. Is there anybody here on earth that wants to receive the fullness thereof, that you want to live the life of a king and a queen and a princess of royalty here on earth. It can be done, kingdom citizen. If you are a kingdom citizen, you should be reaping the benefits. You should not be living below your means and your needs. You should have more than enough. God has called for us to be distributors. We are supposed to be distributions to sinners right here on earth. And that's what God is calling for us. And so what I want to talk about, we're going to talk about spiritual stability. And what do I mean about that? God wants to stabilize you, but first you have to become stable spiritually. Somebody put in there, I have to become spiritually stable. What is it we're talking about? First of all, when we talked about a transformed mind, we're saying, be ye not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by what? The renewing of your mind. As we're having these weekly sessions, it's about transforming your mind so that you may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. We want to do the things that are acceptable to for him. We want to be in his good will. We want to do things that he requires of us. We don't want to just be hearers of the word, but we also want to be doers of the word. So some of you are saying, Apostle, how do we get to this thing called spiritual stability? Well, you have two pieces here. We're talking about not the natural. We talk about the things of God. So we're talking about spiritual things. Come on, somebody. We're talking about spiritual things. And when we're talking about that, God is talking about stabilizing you spiritually. Some of you are unstable. How do we stand firm in the midst of the various trials and temptations? That's what I'm talking about. How do we stand firm? When we talk about firmness, and Paul even talked about it, what are we talking about? How do you persist? How do you preserve yourself? That's what we're going to be talking about. How do you stand strong against the onslaught of the enemy? How do you stand strong when the enemy comes up against you like a flood? That's what we're talking about when we're talking about spiritual stability. What God is trying to do is stabilize you so that you can reap the benefits of the kingdom. And he's doing that by sharing with you what we're sharing this evening is spiritual stability. What God is saying, believers are faced with many ups and downs. We're tossed here and there and everywhere and every various places. It says in the Bible, we're like the waves of the sea. Come on, somebody. You are like the waves of the sea. We're here one moment, we're there the next moment. We believe what God has done, then the next moment, we're doubting him. God wants you to be stable in the things of him. Somebody put in there, stable, stable, stable. He wants you to abstain from sinful desires. Somebody put in there, God wants you to abstain from sinful desires. He wars, they war against our soul. God is calling us up out of sin. Somebody put in there, God is calling us out of sin. He's calling, this is the time now that we don't have time to play with the things of God. We got to be about the kingdom work. We have to do the work of the Lord, and you can't do it living a sinful life. Come on, somebody. Yes, I'm stepping on toes, but what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to get you stabilized spiritually so that you can move forward in the things of 2021. We're talking about clarity for 2021. We know that God wants to stabilize us. I have to ask you the question right now. What is shaking your faith? Somebody put in the question right now. What is shaking your faith? What is it that's causing you to be double-minded? What is it that's causing you to look to the left and then to the right? What's causing you to change from one day to the next? What's causing you to vacillate? If you know the God in which I serve, he's the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. He has not changed. But I need to know, saints of God, and you need to know, what is it spiritually that's causing you to waver and vacillate? So what I'm doing right now, I'm talking to a certain group of people here. This may not apply to everyone, but I'm just going to go through some of the ones here, and maybe this may hit a nerve here. Maybe this may be what God is saying to you. Are you a spiritual infant? Do you need to grow in the things of God? You have to mature, saints of God. We can't stay in the same place. If you're not going forward, you're going backwards. Somebody put in there, if you are not moving forward, you're moving backwards. Come on, somebody. You have to grow. The spiritual infants, you can no longer be a spiritual infant if you want to receive the things of God. If you want to receive receive the fullness thereof. You have to grow up. You got to get off the infamil. You got to get some meat into your body. You got to grow up, saints of God. We continue to grow. We can't be in the same place. I want to talk to the ones that are double-minded. Those of you that keep, you know that you hear the voice of God, and then you allow the enemy to get into your ear. You allow the enemy to trick you. You have conversation with carnal people that have no meaning, no value, that cannot add anything to your life, but you are allowing them to influence what you believe in God. Because of your double-minded, you are slapping God in the face. You're saying, Lord, I don't believe you. Lord, I doubt you. I've seen you do it many times, but I still don't believe that you will do it for me. Come on, somebody. A double-minded man that is unstable in not just one way, but all of their ways. If you look at your life, you can look and see if everything is just all over the place, and you can't decide what to do from one minute to the next. One minute you want to do this, the next minute you want to do that. You are double-minded. I want to talk to the what we call the spiritual surfers. Those are the ones that you just go up and down. You're surfing on the wave. Your spirit emotionally is just all over the place. You're just surfing. You're up and down. Your highs and your lows. Your emotions are just scattered. You're just frustrated. You're happy and you're disappointed, and you're going through all the 8 channels of emotion. Those are what we call spiritual surfers, because you don't know how to stand still and see the salvation. God is calling right now. In order for you to receive the full benefits thereof, he's talking on spiritual stability. That's what we're talking about. We're talking to those that are warring with their soul or their flesh. Those that are fighting against your flesh. You know that you're the things of the world are not that's designed for kingdom, but you still are entertaining those fleshly things. In Romans 7, this is what it says. It says, the things I would do, I don't do, and the things I wouldn't do, I do. Who can save me from this body of sin? Christians are in war with flesh, and they fight to be holy. Somebody right now is fighting to be holy. Oh, come on, somebody. Some of you are fighting to maintain your holiness. Oh my God. Holiness is always right. You cannot go, somebody put in there, holiness is always right. We cannot go wrong by living a holy and a sanctified life. God is calling for us to be holy, to be blemish free, to live a sanctified, be separated from the world. Remember, we're talking about, we're not conformed of this world. We're in this world, but we are yet transformed by what? The renewing of our mind. Saints of God, I'm trying to help you this evening. The spiritual stability that we're talking about, those that are in war with the world, you're fighting against the world because you still want to dip and dab in there. You feel like the world has more going for themselves than what you have, but what you're missing, saints of God, when you have friendship with the world, it is enemy, which is with God. It talks about it in 1 John 3:13. When you get a chance, I want you guys to look it up. Go to 1 John 3:13. John said, do not love the world or the things that are in the world. If a man loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. So you can't tell us, and this is not Apostle Spivey saying this, but this is what the Word of God is teaching us. Come on, somebody. It says that if a man loves the world, he cannot love the Father. It's not in him. If any man loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. You can't say that you love God and you love the world too. You can't love, trying to love two show ain't easy to do. There used to be an old blue song saying, trying to love too is show ain't easy to do. Saints of God, I want you to hear me. Our teaching this evening is what about spiritual stability. I'm trying to help you to get stable in the things of God so that we can exhibit those behaviors of believers, so that people can see the light that lives with us, that resides with us. Come on, somebody. What I want to do, I'm trying to encourage you, whatever you pause in, whatever state you find yourself, you should be in a base. You should be saying, I'm not saying this because I'm in need, but if I have learned to be content, whatever the circumstances, as believers, because we have to be mature enough. We have to be stable enough to know that that is part of a believer's life, that we are going to go through valleys and mountains and peaks. We go up and down. Things will change. We have different seasons. But the one thing that we can hold on to is God's unchanging hand. We know that we are going to be victorious. We are going to be victorious. Somebody put it in there. God, it was so gracious that he told us the expected end. The expected end is that we shall and are victorious. Come on, somebody. We want to have that unsurpassable joy. We need to have a peace and joy no matter what you're in, no matter what state you're in. The peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your heart and your minds in Jesus Christ. That's Philippians 4:7. Somebody type in there. We got to have that joy that no matter what goes on, that people can look at and say, what is it that keeps Apostle Spivey smiling? What is it that that keeps her going? What is it that even in her state of uncomfortableness and her transition, what is it that keeps her going? It's the joy that she has, that unsurpassable peace and joy that God gives us. We have to lean to the things, not to our own understanding. Saints of God, I'm trying to help you this evening. This is what our training is about this evening. It's about being spiritually stable. We got to get spiritually stable, saints of God. We cannot be hearers. We got to be the doers of the word. Don't worry about anything. The Bible says that we're not even supposed to worry about what we're going to eat, what we're going to drink. It tells us that God, whatever you need, he already knows. He knows your needs. He knows your petition. He knows your concern. God is expecting you as a stable, as a mature believer. When we become stabilized in the things and our thinking process in our behaviors, it's a sign of maturity. God is trying to mature us in the things of him. In order to live better, we have to do better. In order to do better, we got to start doing the things in which God has given us to do. That's why we're learning these principles. That's why we're studying these things, so that we can do better, so that we can live a better and a bountiful life. Come on, somebody. Is there anybody out there other than myself desire to have the best things in life, but we want to have the things that matter? We're looking at eternal. Stop looking at material things. Yes, we can get those. Yes, they will happen. As believer, God blesses us. And even for now, he reigns on the unrighteous as well as the righteous. But the thing is, our ultimate goal is eternal life. And that's what we should be striving for, eternal life. What is it that we want to see eternally? What is it that we expect to happen? What is it that, how can you be pleasing unto God if you refuse to obey and to do the things that he has called us to do? When we're being stable in the things of God, when we talk about spiritual stability, we have to learn to rejoice in the Lord always. Somebody put in there, rejoice in the Lord always. We have to learn to rejoice. Do I have any worshipers out there? Do I have any worshipers out there? Is there anybody out there that's a worshiper? Is there anybody out there that understands the significance of being a worshiper, that understands the importance and the value of rejoicing in the Lord always? It says, I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evidence to all. The Lord is near. That's in Philippians, the fourth chapter, verse 1. Paul always can encourage us to stand firm in the word, conduct ourselves in the manner of the gospel of Christ that's worthy. We have to conduct ourselves in a manner in which we are worthy. Somebody put in there, worthy, 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 worthy. We have to be examples so that other people can see the light that lives in. We are an example of Christ here on earth. Is there anybody that's striving for spiritual stability? The Bible says in 1 Corinthians 15:58, I believe, he says, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Let me say that again. It says, be steadfast. Come on, saints. I need some mature saints that you're not going to waver. You're not going to panic, that you're not going to fall down and break because you're going through a trial. But I need you to be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. He's calling for us, saints of God. We have to be stable. We have to mature in the things of God. I want to talk about a couple of areas specifically that God wants us to mature additionally in. We have to be developed. What? First, we start by the first thing that we have to do, our pursuit of intimacy with Christ. In order to be stable spiritually, you must have an intimacy with Christ. Somebody put in there intimacy with Christ. Stability requires that you have an intimacy with Christ. How do you have an intimacy? An intimacy is when you have a personal relationship, when you know this person one-on-one. You don't know him because of what somebody else said, because mama said or grandmama said it, but you know him because your experience with him, that you can go to him and call him Abba, my father. You can call him daddy, papa, because you know that you have that type of relationship. It's very difficult to walk up to someone and call them daddy and you don't have any type of relationship with him. Oh my God. I hope I'm not talking to anybody tonight. I believe I have some saved, sanctified folks on here that have an intimate relationship with God, that they're striving for that intimacy that God is calling for. What else that we need to do as it relates to the intimacy? By knowing Christ and the power of his resurrection, we have to understand the power of the resurrection. We have to understand, what is the resurrection about? What does that mean? The power of the resurrection, his power. When he died on that cross for us, and he was resurrected for our sins so that we may have a life, so that we will have an opportunity. Oh my God. When we talk about intimacy, we must be continuous. We can't just stop, saints of God. This is a lifestyle. Somebody put in there, Christianity believers, this is a lifestyle. This becomes our life. We don't just do this, what we do on Sundays and Wednesday in special programs, but this is a lifestyle. Living holy is a lifestyle. Oh my God. How many of you know that living holy is a lifestyle? When we are believers, it's just like walking on a stream. Things go up and down and they move around, but we cannot remain in the same place, saints of God. If you are not moving forward, hear me and hear me clear. If we're not moving forward in the things of God, we're moving backwards. Come on, somebody. If we're stuck, then Satan has a stronghold on us. What we're trying to do is move forward in the things of God in which he has for us. That's what the maturity is about. That's how God will stabilize us. We have to move forward. We cannot be the same. I can't be the same that I was last year. When we go through all these classes every week, week after week, there ought to be something that has changed about your life. Are there any testimony? Can anybody say on here that something has changed since we started this Transformation Thursday? Maybe you know more of the word. Maybe you've disciplined yourself. Maybe you start to get more into the word. Maybe you're spending more time in your prayer life. Maybe you're fasting more. I have to believe you're not on here week after week and not doing something. There has to be a change. Somebody put in there, there has to be a change. We cannot remain the same. If we're to mature and stabilize, we cannot remain the same. The Bible tells us that we're to what? Press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling, what, of God in Jesus Christ. We got to press toward the mark. Somebody put in there, press, press, press. We got to keep pushing no matter what happens, no matter what it looks like, no matter what you go through, no matter what back set you may have, you still got to push forward. Somebody said, push forward, push, push, push. It's just like when you have a baby, you have to keep pushing, because that baby, what it has to come out, you have to birth. God is saying, oh, thank you, Jesus. God is saying that you got to birth, and your birthing season is now. Your birthing season will come with you stabilizing in the things of Him. As you start to spiritually and mature in the things of God, you're going to start to birth things. Things will start to shift. You're going to start to see things move forward. There's going to be a difference in your life. Things are going to start to open up that you've been looking for. It's going to be a difference in everything. Your income will be different. Your relationships will be different. Your conversation will start to change. Things are going to start to shift as you start to stabilize in the things of God. Oh, come on, saints. I'm getting excited about this, because we press on towards the goal. We want to win the prize. We want to move forward. Oh, my God. We want to press on toward the things that God has for us. We're in this to win it. Somebody put in there, we're in this to win it. We're not in it to stay where we are. We got to position ourselves so that we can move forward, so that we can see more, that we can experience more. Is there anybody out there that wants different, that wants better? Is there anybody out there right now that's saying to yourself, I have to believe there's somebody out there saying, Lord, there has to be more to this, that there's more to life. I know that, Lord, even with me going through what I've been through, I've seen more, I've traveled more, I experienced more, I've visited more places, I've lived in different places. Is there anybody right there that can say, Lord, I know that it is more that you're calling for me to stabilize myself spiritually, that you expect and you desire of me to seek Him in all the things of His ways, that you will do better, that you will make a commitment, that you will stretch out on faith and start to mature in the things of God. Lord, we just think, I just hear it, Lord. I hear you right now. God is saying, grow up, saints. Grow up, grow up, grow up, grow up. Stop looking for crutches and letting people hold, looking for folks to hold on to. You can't continue to lean on mom. You can't continue to lean on dad. You can't continue to lean on your pastor. There becomes a point in your spiritual walk that you got to show some insight. You got to show some example. You got to show people that you know the word of God and that you live this thing out. Remember, we're our doers and not just hearers of the word. I want to talk about one more area of spiritual stability, and then we're going to pick this up next week. One other area is we need to be in harmony in the body of Christ. Oh, my God. Somebody put in there harmony. Harmony, harmony. God is calling. In order for God to stabilize you in the things of the kingdom, we have to be in harmony in the body of Christ. Let me just give you a few examples of what that means. We have to remain free from conflict. Somebody put in there, remain free from conflict. That is not Christ-like. That is not kingdom. That is not what we do as believers. We run from conflict. It is attack. It's a tactic of the enemy. It is the enemy's desire to kill, steal, and destroy your life, and he will use any kind of way to get you off of course. God is calling for us to stay free of conflict. In order to stay in harmony, in order to be spiritually stable, we have to run from conflict. Oh my God. Another thing is, a house divided against itself cannot stand. Hear me again. There is no harmony in a house that's divided against itself. It cannot stand. We're looking for God to stabilize something. I believe in 2021, God is going to stabilize the household, that he's going to bring all, he's going to save your children. He's going to save your spouses. He's going to save every person that you're connected with, people that you have been praying for. God is saying that I'm going to stabilize that household so that you can be on one accord, so that everybody can pray together, they can worship together, that there will be a difference in the household, says the Lord. You cannot stand in harmony in the things in the body of Christ if you are on two different accords. Oh my God. The enemy, what does he do? He seeks to bring division in, not only in the household, but he also is trying to bring havoc into the body of Christ, into the house of God. He's trying to separate people in the kingdom, also in the body of Christ. He is trying to separate us. He's trying to bring friction. We're all one body, one mind, one side. We're supposed to be building the kingdom together. We're co-laborers, but yet we're bickering, we're fighting, we're doing undermining things, we're manipulating, we're showing up on folks' platform, we're lying and we're sneaking and cheating and copycatting, trying to copy anointing. Oh my God, that's another message for another time. But we're talking about harmony in the body of Christ. God is trying to stabilize us. And that's one thing that he's calling for. If we're bringing conflict, we need to check ourselves. He's also addressing the area of unresolved conflict. If you have an altar against someone, if in your anger you do not sin, do not let the sun go down, and you're still angry and did not bow the devil at a foothold. Saints of God, we cannot be angry with people and hold these grudges. We have to go to them. If you have an altar with your brother and sister, go to them. Have a conversation. Things can be worked out. When you are a believer, your heart is not going to allow you to hold animosity. You cannot be a believer of Christ and hold animosity and hate and bitterness and anger. Somebody put in there, we cannot harbor bitterness, hatred, and anger. That is not harmony in the bottom of Christ. If we want to be stabilized spiritually, we have to come beyond that. We got to grow above that. Sometimes you got to take the high road to bring peace among the brethren. Come on, somebody. Sometimes you have to suck it up. Sometimes you have to say, you know what? You may not even be wrong. I don't know about you, but I found myself in situation just to keep the peace, to keep the harmony. I apologize for something I didn't even do, but I accepted it, because if I knew that that will bring that person around, that will create an environment where they can move forward in the things of God. Sometimes, saints of God, we have to take a hit in the kingdom. Somebody put in there, sometimes we have to take one for the kingdom. Oh my God. The bottom line is that we should be thinking like Christ. In order to spiritually stabilize, we got to start to think like Christ. Somebody put in there, think like Christ. Think like Christ. We got to fix our relationships, not only with Christ, but we need to fix any relationship that is damaged. Don't allow this year to pass us by and go into 2021 and your relationships have not been fixed. Whatever that fix looks like, you need to fix that relationship. God will give you the strategy. He will tell you what to do, how to do it, and when to do it. The point is, it's not for you to beg for them to accept and forgive you. Your responsibility, your kingdom obligation is to go to that person and fix that situation. Come on, you. Some of you got some broken relationships and you know it. Oh my God. The Bible tells us and it commands us, it says, whoever loves God must also love his brother. How can you say that you love God and who you have not seen and don't even love your brother? Oh my God. How can you love somebody and call them your brother and your sister and then say that you love God? Oh my, it does not work. It does not work. You can't say that and you don't love your own biological brothers and your sister. It does not matter what they've done to you. You forgive them whether they forgive you and accept it or not. Come on, somebody. I'm trying to help you to stabilize in the spiritual things of God. We got to let this stuff go, y'all. We want to move into a new year with a clean slate so that we can be ready to do what God is calling us to do in the year of 2021. God wants to stabilize us. We need to maintain the joy that God has. I'm coming to an end right now, but I want to pray for some of you right now. We'll pick up on part two of this next week. We'll pick up on part two. And what we're talking about is spiritual stability. I want you all to think about it this week, from this week until the time we meet next Thursday at the same time, 6 p.m. I want you to think about spiritual stability. What areas of my life do I need to stabilize my spiritual life? Come on, somebody. We talked about relationship. Is it that you need to get it right with the Lord? Come on, somebody. We have to be honest with ourselves. If we want to go forward, do you have the peace that God is calling you to have? Do you have that joy that God speaks about? Are you double-minded? Are you wavering? Are you back and forth here and there and everywhere? What area do you need to be stabilized in? We're going to continue to talk about it. I would even start with the fruit of the Spirit. Start to pick up there and read over in Galatians where it talks about the different spirits of the fruit. The Spirit is one, but we talk about the fruit of the Spirit. And so we want to start thinking about where do we need to build in the area of spiritual stability. I want to pray for you all right now. Dear God, if I'm just coming before you, humbling myself, standing in proxy, interceding on behalf of the people that are on this live, God. Lord, even those that will listen to the replay. Lord, we're calling right now that your people will stabilize themselves spiritually, that they will be sound, that they will be solid, that they will be made whole in all areas of their lives, their mind, their soul, their spirit, their body, Lord, that they can be the example, that they won't waver, that they won't become weak, that they won't become weary, God, but they understand that this is part of the process in order to reign with you, God. You have told us that there we have to go through, Lord. So, Lord, we're asking right now is that you would teach us through this spiritual maturity process as we stabilize, how do we go through this process, Lord, and not draw weary, Lord. Lord, we thank you for the teaching tonight, God. Lord, we thank you for what we're hearing, God, your kingdom keys, your laws, your principle, your promises, Lord. Lord, keep us and let us be not only hearers, but to be doers, to be the examples, God. And more importantly, Lord, let this become a lifestyle, Lord. Let this become us every day, 365, Lord. Let us be this way all the way. Let us live holy and pleasing unto you, acceptable unto your will, Almighty God. Lord, we thank you right now. We thank you for this transformation Thursday, God, for allowing a platform to be established where we can teach and people can hear what they need to hear to be successful as believers and Christians in the body of Christ. Lord, we thank you. We thank you. We honor you and we give you all the glory in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you for each and every person. I pray that you, God, are blessed. I hope this has been a great evening. Please join me back next Thursday. I'm on every Thursday at 6 o'clock for transformation training. This is where we're being renewed in our mind. Our mindsets are being shifted. God is doing a new thing. He wants to do a new thing in your life. We want to be pleasing and acceptable in the things in which we do in the kingdom. I love you guys. I am Dr. Regina Spivey. God bless you, your family. Until we meet again, please share this video. Let people know that we're here. Thank you for coming on, and please come back next week at the same time. God bless you. I'll love you a lot. God bless you.